I'm all in on AI, and in this video, I'm going to show you how you can speed up your software development workflow while keeping Sam Altman's grubby little fingers off your source code. This video is not sponsored. This is my new AI workstation, and you're going to see it a lot on this channel. It's become my new daily driver, and it can run large language models like Mixtral at greater than 50 tokens per second. It's rocking dual 3090s, giving it 48 gigabytes of available VRAM. And unlike some other AI workstations I've seen, you don't need to call an electrician for this one. It uses less than 100 watts with the AI models fully loaded in the VRAM, and less than 900 watts under full load. At the heart of this build is the BD790i from MiniSwarm that we looked at a few videos ago. This board supports 8x8 bifurcation, which allows us to pair the dual Nvidia 3090s with a 32-thread AMD processor, 96 gigabytes of RAM, and additionally, I've installed a 10 gigabit NIC and a Gen 5 NVMe drive, which supports over 14 gigabytes per second read speeds. At this point, you should be asking, but Matt, isn't that an ITX board? How will you plug both the GPUs in? Doesn't it only have a single slot? Well, this is a Gen 4 PCIe bifurcation adapter. So we can split that single PCIe 16X slot into two 8x slots. And that'll allow us to plug in both GPUs. I've tried this trick on my MSI B650i motherboard as well, and it works great. Unfortunately, your motherboard has to support this feature. So at this time, the AR900i, for instance, that we featured in the last video, cannot do this. I want to very quickly talk about cooling. These GPUs get hot. This is a very interesting case from Geometric Future, which has a rotated motherboard design and allows us to run both of the GPUs vertically. When you run them in a normal case, what happens is that the GPUs are very close together and you can't get airflow between them. So I've gone ahead and installed Rocky Linux and a lot of my initial dependencies, such as the NVIDIA drivers. I've put a full walkthrough on my GitHub and you can find a link in the description. If I go ahead and run NVIDIA SMI, you'll see that both GPUs are detected and they're in an idle state and you'll see no processes running. It's actually very important that you do an initial setup. Even if you plug your display into your integrated graphics, by default, Linux is actually going to still try to use your GPUs to accelerate window management. Because we want all the GPU RAM we can get, we want to make sure we disable this. So what we want to do is we want to go into our X11 settings. And in our configurations, we'll find a NVIDIA comp. And you can see I've commented all this out. This is my AMD integrated graphics, and that's what everything's running off of. But by default, you're going to have basically this configuration out of the box. You'll need to comment all of this out in order to have your window management run on your AMD driver and not on your NVIDIA driver. For the last year, I've been trying to revive a project called Postgres for WordPress. There's some open issues, so let's see if we can use AI to solve them. We're going to start by installing Continue. Continue will allow us to use large language models without leaving our IDE. And because we're running all of our large language models locally, none of the data will leave our machine. Out of the box, Continue is going to expect you to use cloud-based models, but for our use case, we're going to use local ones. So for that, what we're going to do is we're going to first configure Llama.cpp. So we're going to start by cloning this repository into a local directory. We'll go ahead and clone this. Then we want to go into that directory. Now, if we look at the repository, there's some instructions for compiling with CUDA support. In addition, you need to make sure that your NVCC compiler is in the path. This is the path for me, user local CUDA 12.5 bin. So I'm just adding that. You can see NVC is working. We're gonna go ahead and compile it. All right, looks like it finished. So we're gonna go ahead and split this. All right. And so now we have a binary available called Llama CLI. We don't have any models yet. We're gonna need to pick out two different AI models. So when we're using Continue, there's two different large language models you'll interact with. There is one which is used for autocomplete, and then one you can just chat with in the UI. It's not necessary to run both of them, but for the sake of this, I wanted to show both. For the model we can just chat with, I'm going to use Mixtral. It's a mixture of experts model. I think we can run the 4KM version of the model. What's going to be limiting for us is the amount of VRAM we have total, right? For our autocomplete model, we're going to use Dolphin Coder, which is a variant of StarCoder 2, a autocomplete model designed specifically for coding with an open and permissive license. We should have enough video memory to be able to run a 6K quant in addition to our 4K Mixtral model. So this is going to be all about trade-offs, right? So you have an autocomplete model, and then you have a model you can chat with. So you can kind of choose, do you want less accuracy on your autocomplete and better chat? Or do you want a better autocomplete and a worse chat? You could also forego the autocomplete or forego the chat. So once you download the models, you want to go ahead and put them in the models folder. And then we're going to go ahead and launch our two models. So what we want to go ahead and do is launch Llama server. And we want to pass NGL, and then 99 is what I'm using. This specifies the number of layers that you'd like to offload to the GPUs. I'm specifying 99 because I just want all of the layers on the GPU. In the event you wanted to run a model that was larger than your available VRAM, you could specify a lower number and offload only some of the layers to your GPU. You'll still get a speed up. So we're going to go ahead and run fully offloaded to the GPU, specify the Mixtral model, or the 4KM model. And you can see that on our left window here, we've now fully offloaded this to the GPU. So I'm going to go ahead and switch down to our bottom window here. And what I'm going to do is start another server instance. And I'll need to run this one on a different port. So the first one above was running on 8080, so we'll run on 8081. And what I'm going to do is offload all of our layers again, and I'll specify our StarCoder model instead. So we're using Dolphin Coder, and I'll show you what happens if you try to run a model that has not enough memory here. Basically what's gonna happen is that we're not gonna have enough memory. So you can see our CUDA buffer fails to allocate. For this one, we're going to specify our Dolphin Coder model. We can run the 6K quant. So now we've got both models loaded into our VRAM. And you can see that our GPUs aren't really consuming much more wattage. Our idle state on this machine is less than 100 watts. So we've got, you know, 30 watts per GPU and roughly 40 watts for the system. Jumping into VScode, we need to go ahead and install the continue extension. This extension is going to ask you to configure all your AI models. Go ahead and ignore all of that. What you're going to want to do is open the command prompt. And you're going to want to open the config.json. On my GitHub page, you'll find a reference configuration which you can use. This configuration is made up of the chat model along with the system prompt that we're going to use, any custom commands we want to define, and finally our tab autocomplete model. You'll want to make sure that the port matches the port of our running server for each of the respective models. So what's it like to code with an AI assistant? Well, as an example, I know that the following piece of code has a bug. It's supposed to be case insensitive, but it's not. So let's ask our chat model what's wrong with this function and see if it can get it. So we can go ahead and highlight this function, and then we can press Control plus L, and we can ask it. This function should be case insensitive, but something is wrong. Can you spot the issue? And sure enough, our AI model has recognized that we missed the I in our first regex here. Now, if we want, what we can do is we can go ahead and apply this. And it's going to run through and show all the changes. And the only one I want is this first one. So I'll just go ahead and accept this one. And then I'll reject the rest. Well, what else can we do? Well, how about a doc block? We can go and highlight this function. We can open up the command palette, and under continue, there's an option to write a doc string for this code. So let's go ahead and enter that, and we'll see what it does. And here we have our newly written doc string. And you should notice that it is able to figure out the meaning of this function, even though it wasn't contained here in the function we highlighted. It's actually using the full context. What else can we do? Well, I don't actually need to do this, but as an example, why don't we generate some code? So if we go into continue, you'll find that there's a generate code function. And this is going to ask us what we want to do. So we'll say a PHP function to remove spaces from a string. And that's going to go ahead and generate that for us. And now we have our new helper function, and we can just accept it. It's that easy. So how about that autocomplete model? As we actually type, you'll start to see that we get autocomplete, where it's trying to finish our sentences. And so we can say, for instance, now remove the spaces. And as I move to the next line, you'll see that it's already put the code in place. And if we hit tab, we now have that code. Now, I do want to give a disclaimer that if you're planning to accelerate your software development workflow with AI, I highly recommend that you write a robust test suite. AI is not perfect, obviously, and it can miss a lot of things. Oftentimes when I'm coding with AI, I'll find that it will oversimplify a problem or it won't actually solve the problem that I asked it to. Having a robust test suite makes sure that the AI model didn't inadvertently break something that you don't realize. Hopefully this gives you a sense though for why someone would want an AI inference workstation. Make sure to leave a comment down below and star my repo on GitHub. That helps me know that you're human. I plan to make many follow-up videos to this one using this AI inference workstation for its intended purpose. If you have any models that you'd like me to try out, please leave them down in the comments. I won't be running any sort of gaming benchmarks, but I'm happy to run things like different text models, stable diffusion, tortoise text-to-speech, whatever it might be that you think would be helpful. That's it for today, so I hope you have a great rest of your day. But remember, Sam Altman will not save you from the robot overlords.
In the world of tech and startups, there's a man named Sam with a reputation that precedes him. But there's something about him that I just can't ignore. Sam Altman, oh Sam Altman. Grab your little fingers. Sam Altman, oh Sam Altman. Grab your little fingers. From ideas to companies, he's got a knack for finding the next big thing. But have you ever stopped to wonder just what is Sam Altman really up to? What's his master plan? Sam Altman, oh Sam Altman. Grab your little fingers. Sam Altman, oh Sam Altman. Grab your little fingers. Ideas to companies, he's got a knack for finding the next big thing. But have you ever stopped to wonder just what is Sam Altman really up to? What's his master plan?